Welcome to another Guitar Night Gallery, where a frickin' cartoon of yourself could actually become reality. Believe it.
Oh, I don't know. I guess it's like episode too many of the Night Gallery. But hey, we're fixing up. Look, I glued the fingerboard back on the gem tone. And after much thinking, I decided to just try and fix what was broken. I know there was a lot of great suggestions. Oh, just take the entire... No, don't take the entire fingerboard off. And you're going to break that whole edge, which broke there. Which is another repair where the transition is between the binding and the actual neck. So after looking at it a lot, the wood of the neck was straight. And because the fingerboard had whatever, I don't even want to know why it was separated. It had sort of done its own thing because it was left open grain doing nothing. So I decided to rely on the straightness of this wood and glue this sucker back together. I'm going to take the clamps off. You're here with me. I've made other progress, but you know, this could be a fail. This could spring off like a diving board.
I'm not going to say anything. That one came off. At least the clamps aren't glued to the neck. That one came off. Oh, it hasn't blown up yet. This was the one that was really doing all the work, because that's where the big bow was. Well, it didn't blow up. Let's put a straight edge on it. Truss rod is disengaged. I made sure of that. Just gonna double check that again. Yeah, it's not doing anything. So if I just eyeball it, that ain't looking bad. It's got a little bit of a dip here, but let's see what happens. I'm just going to level all the frets and try and fix that anyway, but once again, until you put string tension on it, it's really, really difficult to see what's going to happen. We're just thinking what's going to happen. So, and she starts to get some neck relief there. So, if I tighten the truss rod, theoretically, this could straighten out. I need a different 5mm. So, this is the moment of truth, because like when I tension this, if this all pops apart. Well, guess what, folks? Thanks for hanging out. I'm still not getting any tension. Don't tell me this doesn't work at all. Okay, hang on. It's okay. It was just really loosened off a lot. More than I thought. Well, who knows what happened while it was sitting all clamped. But now we got some tension on it. And it should be doing what it's supposed to do by now. If it's doing anything. Doesn't seem like it's doing anything. I don't want to force it. I'd rather do the heat press and help this. Give it one more, like a quarter turn, and the fingerboard snaps off it. I quit this kind. We'll do the heat press and really help it. See, it's really not moving things, and I don't want to crank it. So we're going to loosen it and just leave it. So that's the next adventure. A little heat press action to this guy. Let's move on to the, what the hell is it? My L-Dig ass. I'll be right back.
Look what happened to the L-Dig ass. I pulled out those posts, put in bushings. We got this guy here, which is looking like it wants to go the other way around. But hey, that could work out. Let's just have a look.
Other than the fact that this needs a whole big
pile of cleanup, or at least the pickups, and might be able to do something with those bear claw marks in the front. Don't have any idea what happened there. But it's a set neck. Oh, it needs a new nut, which I'm not scared about. But that looks, let's just play with this like we would if we were going to play with it. Crank that guy up, or I'd like to see it. But that's really good and solid. This thing weighs a ton. It's got a huge plank of metal in the middle of it. Huge plank of metal, huge plank of wood. So, yeah, we're going to be able to get the string action really nice where it should be. What else? I think all the electronics works. It's just a mess. Once again, rusty screws. And I think the nut width is something similar to an Epiphone, or possibly a Gibson, or maybe we gotta make one or find one. We'll get to that portion sooner or later. Yes, it's beautiful fret wire. Jeskar Evo Golds. Harder than nickel, easier to work with than stainless, but almost as good. And it's going in one of those over there. Let's have a look and figure it out. It's just a bunch of frets and a bunch of slots and wood. Wire and wood. So what we figured out is that the fingerboard is a 14-inch radius. And we need to spin this wire a little bit tighter than 14. Not much, but a little bit more. And I still gotta find the tool I need to clean all the slots out properly. Okay. Make sure the wood is as straight as it can be. And right now it is. And I'm still searching for that little tool that I made where I ground one of these down. This is the one. Really, let me clean those out and get ready. Okay, time to roll a little fret wire. I'm not even gonna put this in the vise. It's so close to being flat. Right. Oh, where's the gauge? So if I wanted 14, we'll tweak that a little bit. Here we go. You only get to screw this up once, but that, I'm not going to touch it. I could tighten it a tiny bit and slightly over radius. You can do it, which I might do. It's always good to go through twice as well, just because we can. You can do it. Just look at that again, and I think that's going to be just perfect, but a little bit more. Just a little bit. Is it slightly more than what you want?
So it'll help things grab. What'd we end up with? I'm gonna go with that. Hang in there. Okay, I'm gonna do one, then I quit. Especially if it turns out like ass. So I'm gonna take this little diamond shaped square file, triangular file, whatever you like to call it, put a little chamfer in there, and get rid of the dust. I don't cut all kinds of frets. I do one at a time. And I want to leave about that much over the edge of that. And with this stuff, I'm going to get a little marker. Just because it's so shiny and slippery and new. I want that to live about like that, which means we're going to cut it off there. Take these guys and cut one fret. You can do it, David. Okay. Now, what I need to do, just sort of have another eyeball where that's going to live. Something like that. Now we need to get rid of the tang. Because the tang is killing us. Because it's in the way of the binding. Another reason I like to do these one at a time is that those little bits are hard to track, and I like to clean them up after each fret. And I mean, we could get all fancy and we could get the fret barber and all that wonderful shit that they sell, but this is going to do the job. You watch. Are we ready? Yes, we are. Okay, with 20 some odd more to go. Working for me.
Well, that's a pile of brand new wires. Now comes the fun. All the nasty work is done. I must have poked. It doesn't matter how many times I do this, I always goon myself somehow. But that, I love the look of that fret wire. That's nice. And it was really nice to work with. I don't play with stainless steel, only because I just don't. This is nice stuff. Right there. Okay, all the nasty shit's over with. Now we're going to make all the fret ends nice. Then we get to level them all, even though they're brand new, crown them and polish them, and then it's going to be good. I'm a little sad that somebody started for me, because they sort of made more work, but at least they bailed before they wrecked it. I gotta do one for the headphone fans. Just like Dave's factory. When someone asks me to perform a ridiculous task at work, my response usually is, I'll be right back. I have to go crochet a saxophone. Brand new frets. Just look at them. Don't try this at home and then give it to somebody to try and finish it. That's all I gotta say.